U.S. President to meet with the leaders of all 10 ASEAN countries. I've sustained
our cooperation throughout my presidency. Earlier this year, I was proud to host the first U.S.-ASEAN summit in the United States at Sunnylands, California. Our meeting here in Laos was our eighth meeting, and this visit marks my ninth to the ASEAN region, more than any U.S. president. Together, the United States and ASEAN have forged a strategic partnership guided by key principles, including that ASEAN will remain central to peace, prosperity, and progress in the Asia Pacific. The United States is now firmly part of the East Asia Summit, and we have worked to make that organization the region's leading forum for dealing with political and security challenges, including maritime security. And we're guided by the shared vision of the region that we put forward at Sunnylands: open, dynamic, and competitive economies, mutual security and the peaceful resolution of disputes, and respect for human rights. In short, a region where all nations play by the same rules. That's a vision that we advanced here. We're stepping up our efforts to increase trade and investment. As part of the initiative I announced earlier this year, U.S.-ASEAN Connect, we're doing more to connect our businesses and investors so that it is easier to start new ventures together. More to connect our entrepreneurs, so we're encouraging innovation in what are increasingly digital economies. More to connect clean energy projects as we pursue a low-carbon future, all of which will also reinforce this region's continued economic integration through the ASEAN community. And given that four ASEAN nations are also part of the Trans-Pacific Partnership, I reiterated that I am determined to do everything I can to encourage the U.S. Congress to approve TPP before I leave office. With regard to security, our nations reaffirmed our commitment to a regional order where international rules and norms are upheld and where disagreements are resolved peacefully. There was recognition of the importance of the international arbitration ruling in July, which is legal and binding, and which clarified maritime claims by the Philippines and China in the South China Sea. We discussed the importance of claimants adhering to steps to which they've already agreed, including respecting international law, not militarizing disputed areas, and not occupying uninhabited islands, reefs, and shoals. And I reiterated that the United States will stand with allies and partners in upholding fundamental interests, among them the freedom of navigation and overflight, lawful commerce that is not impeded, and peaceful resolution of disputes. The United States and ASEAN also continue to deepen our cooperation on transnational challenges. We discussed the importance of continuing to share information to prevent terrorism and the flow of foreign fighters. Given the threat of climate change to all our nations, especially countries in this region, we agreed on the importance of bringing the Paris Agreement into force as soon as possible. We agreed to cooperation in the fight against human trafficking, including sharing more information on smugglers, closer law enforcement cooperation, and more support for victims. And at the East Asia Summit, our 18 nations expressed our grave concern about North Korea's provocative missile launches, highlighted the threat posed by its nuclear and ballistic missile programs, and called on North Korea to uphold its international obligations. And finally, I'm especially pleased that we continue to deepen the connections between the people of ASEAN and America, particularly our young people, like the inspiring young men and women that I met with at our town hall yesterday. Our Young Southeast Asian Leaders Initiative is now then 100,000 strong. The Women's Leadership Academy that I announced yesterday will support women leaders in business, government, and civil society throughout ASEAN. And we're going to help increase language skills among students and teachers through our English for All program. In closing, I'm mindful that this is the last day of my last trip to this region as president. And when I think back to the time that I spent here as a boy, I can't help but be struck by the extraordinary progress that's been made across so much of the region in the decades since, even as there's still a lot of work to be done. And so it means a great deal to me, not only as president, but also personally, that over the past 8 years, we've increased cooperation between ASEAN countries and the United States. It is unprecedented, the breadth and depth of our relationships, and I think it's one of the most successful parts of our rebalance policy. We've made it clear that the United States will continue to stand with the people of this region in advancing their security, prosperity, and dignity, including universal human rights, and I am very optimistic that the ties of friendship between our people, as reflected by that room full of young people that we saw yesterday, will bring us even closer